Good morning and welcome back to our latest daily devotional video. We're continuing to go through the Psalms. When lockdown began, I thought it'd be a good idea to dive into the Psalms every day because we wouldn't be able to meet up in person. I thought it'd be good to do it as a youth team. I had no idea how long it would last. Would we get up to Psalm 10? 20? I was really surprised when we got to Psalm 50. And yeah, just sitting down now to record a video on Psalm 91. And we really have been in lockdown for a long, long time, haven't we? And it's worth thinking about the positives of that as well as the negatives. Maybe you're feeling rubbish this morning. Maybe you're feeling all right. Maybe it's so early in the morning that you don't know how you're feeling. That's okay too. One thing I want us to know, and I think it sums up this psalm really well, is that what we see in Psalm 91 is that the believer, the faithful Christian, or in Old Testament times, the faithful member of God's covenant, can have faith and confidence in God through all manner of trials and challenges. The faithful believer can have confidence through all manner of trials and challenges. And that works for both Israel as a nation, as we'll get into in a minute, but it also works for the individual, for the lone person, for me, for you. We're going to look at 3 points today. Number one, what is fast becoming my favourite word in the Bible. It's in the Psalms in loads of different places. And it pops its head up a few times in this psalm. Point one, God is my refuge. God is my refuge. And we see that in verses 1 to 2. After that, we're going to see that God is our protection. He is our protection in verses 3 to 8. And then we're going to see that his angels watch over us in verses 9 to 13. And then I forgot to add on that point 4 is us being delivered by God in verse 14 to 16. Let me pray, let me read it, and then let's dive in. Lord God, we come to you in all manner of different trials, in all manner of different contexts and situations, both global and personal. And we're aware that although our struggles might not be as dramatic or indeed as serious as those worldwide in the wider persecuted church, they are ours and we still feel them. And so as we pray for ourselves, we also pray and that you would be the refuge and protection for those of our brothers and sisters who suffer more than us, and it's a harder struggle, a deadly struggle often, to live for Jesus. That is a blessing. It's a blessing that we don't have that. But we lift up ourselves and all who call on your name and ask you to give them by your Holy Spirit the faith and confidence in you to succeed and survive through all manner of challenges by being faithful to Jesus Christ. Amen. Psalm 91, here we go. He who dwells in the shelter of the Most High will abide in the shadow of the Almighty. I will say to the Lord, my refuge and my fortress, my God, in whom I trust. For he will deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with his pinions, and under his wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness is a shield and a buckler. You will not fear the terror of the night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor the pestilence that stalks in darkness, nor the destruction that wastes at noonday. 1,000 may fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come near you. You will only look with your eyes and see the recompense of the wicked. Because you have made the Lord your dwelling place, the Most High, who is my refuge, no evil shall be allowed to befall you, no plague shall come near your tent. For he will command his angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. On their hands they will bear you up, lest you strike your foot against a stone. You will tread on the lion and the adder, the young lion and the serpent you will trample underfoot. Because he holds fast to me in love, I will deliver him. I will protect him because he knows my name. When he calls to me, I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will rescue him, and honour him. With long life I will satisfy him and show him my salvation. Point one, God is my refuge. We're looking at verses 1 to 2 for this, although we see the word refuge come up in verse 2, in verse 4, and later on in verse 9. I want to say we're seeing that most clearly from verses 1 to 2. If we dwell, if we're in the shadow of the Most High, if we're with God, then we have that relationship that's open enough to say, Lord, I come to you in times of trouble because you are my refuge. You are my protection, my fortress. What an image. A fortress where you are safe when you're inside. When you're in the shadow of the fortress, nothing can get in. You're protected. It's the same when you seek refuge in God. If an army is rampaging towards you and you've got a choice to run left towards the fortress or run right into the desert, where are you going? That's right, you're going to the fortress because you know that's your protection. For the Christians, it's the same. We're Muppets when we run away from God. There's no protection out there. Make our refuge the Lord. Point two, God is our protection. And we see this in verses 3 to 8. What does it look like that God is our fortress? What does it look like that God is our refuge? Well, we go from that kind of military image of fortress to a very different kind of picture in verse 4. He describes the people of Israel in the Exodus as under his wing, and he does it again here. It's a picture, a metaphor that God loves to use to describe himself as a mother hen protecting his chicklets, his chicks, his people. He will cover you with his pinions. That's a wing. He will cover you with his wings, and under his wings you will find refuge. And then we flip again from that soft, motherly, gentle, caring image. The end of verse 4, his faithfulness is a shield and buckler. Go back to the warrior image, the might. So we see that our protection comes from a God who is our refuge, and a God who is loving and caring like a mother hen, but also strong and mighty like a warrior. Point 3, his angels will watch over us, verses 9 to 13. Angels, right. Angels are real. Cool. That's a thing we don't often seem to really dive into as a subject. Angels are real. Are they Angel Gabriel-like? Kind of just come and say nice things. Don't worry, you're going to have a baby, it's going to be great. Are they kind of revelation angels with like swords and warriors and in a big war? Who are they fighting? Do they have nothing better to do than just watchers and protectors? What are angels? Lots of questions on that, and that's understandable. But what we see from this passage is the angels are under the command of God, verse 11. And God protects his people by setting angels to guard us in all our ways. They bear us up, they hold us up in verse 12. Does that mean we have guardian angels? Probably going a bit off tangent in this. Yes and no. No, the Bible doesn't say you've got an angel sat on your shoulder looking out for you like a fairy godmother. But we are told that angels will look after us. And angels are mighty warriors who defeat the enemies of God. God thinks we're worthy of protection. Point 4, God will deliver us. And we see this in 14 to 16. This is where the psalm kind of switches focus. For most of it, it's the psalmist praying to God. But actually, God answers in 14 to 16. It's God speaking when he says, because he, the faithful one, will hold fast to me in love, I will deliver him. I will protect him because he knows my name. We have that relationship. He's in my shadow. We're together. So when he calls to me, I'm not going to ignore him. I'm going to answer him. Because I'm going to be with him in trouble. I will rescue him and honour him. It's a promise. It's an action that God will do. I will rescue him and honour him. With long life, I will satisfy him and show him my salvation. God is our refuge. Run to him. God is our protection. Mighty like a warrior. Loving and caring like a mother bird. He thinks we're important enough to protect, and so he sets his angels to watch over us. And he will deliver us. We've seen that on the cross as Jesus fulfills the ultimate deliverance of saving us from our sins. But God will see that through to completion. He will, verse 14, he will, verse 14, he will, verse 15, will, verse 15, will, verse 15, will, verse 16. God will do what he says he will do. And he will grant us that long life that we will enjoy for all of our salvation, for all of eternity. Psalm 91 is great news. Let's pray. Lord, it might be hard for us to realise that we're worthy of your protection, that we're worthy of that relationship with you. Get rid of that thought, Lord. Get rid of it for us. Whether we're worthy or not, you've made us worthy as you washed us with the blood of Jesus. And so we are your children, and we can come to you in confidence. We can run to you for our protection. We can have faith in your might as a warrior, and we can have faith and confidence that you love us and will care for us. Lord, satisfy us, protect us, deliver us, keep us holding fast to you, and show us your salvation, we pray. In Jesus' name.